I'm Alan Irwin with Santa Barbara Infrared, and in this video we're going to be talking about boresight. This is the first of our geometry tests, and unfortunately the name has some ambiguity. You'll also hear this test referred to as the line of sight or LOS test. They're basically the same procedurally, they get applied slightly different, and that's why they have two different names. But as we talk about it here, it's basically the same test. So, what does boresight measure? Boresight measures the position of a point in the field of view of the camera and compares that position to what the expected position would be based on the geometry of the camera and its position in the overall system. More simply, is my camera pointing where I think it is? Now this gets applied different ways. One of the first is when you're actually making sure that the camera is properly aligned to your test system, your optical system. You can make adjustments and you're making sure that the camera is looking down the primary optical axis. Another important use of this test is to make sure that your weapon system is properly aligned. You want to make sure that the sight, or the sensor in this case, is pointing the weapon where you expect it to be. And this is the geometry test that allows you to do that. The third application is when you have a multi-sensor system, such as trying to perform fusion. You may have a visible sensor and an infrared camera, and you're trying to make sure that they're both overlaying each other properly, and the first step is to make sure they are aligned or coaxial, both looking in the same direction, and that's what this boresight test does. You're also interested in them being coplanar, but that's a different test that we'll talk about later. The primary result of a line of sight test is the offset, the error. How far off of our expected position do we actually look at a point? And that is typically an angular measurement, milliradians, and we go about the procedure to measure that offset. And this would be the important image. This is an alignment image as seen in the camera. That spot is properly positioned to represent where we expect the system to be looking. So what we need to do is take an image from the camera and analyze the position of that spot to determine the error. The way we do that is using something called blob analysis, and that's the actual name of this field of applied mathematics. Our first step in that blob analysis is to determine the blob, and that means which pixels are candidates for being part of that blob, connected set of pixels. Here we show a cross-sectional view of a spot as we would see it in the camera, and we can determine the baseline and the maximum value in that spot, and we can set a threshold, in this case in the image you see a 50% threshold, that's the cutoff point. And all the pixels below that we can ignore, and all those pixels that have values above that are part of our candidate set. Doesn't have to be 50%, that's the most typical value, and that's how we're showing it here. Once we have all those pixels, we have to determine which ones are connected. We are looking for a cluster of pixels, these are the terms used. And a cluster of pixels are all those that are touching together into one unit. And for a blob analysis, we include diagonal connectivity. So in this image, you're seeing one blob. These four pixels are together in one cluster or blob. Once we have those pixels that are in our blob, and it's typically the largest blob that we've got in our field of view, we are then going to run a centroid analysis. This is a weighted average, the weighting being the value of the pixel. And we go through the formula that you see here in the X and the Y axes to determine the center point, or the basically the brightest point, but it's the weighted brightest point in both the X and Y axis. And that determines the precise position, usually to a subpixel level, of that spot, the center point of that spot. We are going to compare that to the expected result to determine our error offset. So what do we need to do this test? Well, we need a thermal source. We typically use a blackbody. Doesn't need to be precise, but we need to be in the linear range of the response of the camera. We also need a pinhole target. That allows us to determine a position, and we need to know where that is precisely, and we generally do that by using a target projection system. So we're going to be using something not in a flood, but in a carefully focused system, that's the target projection system, that allows us to know exactly where that pinhole is, typically the primary optical axis of your optical system. The final piece of all this is perhaps the most important, and that's how you mount the camera, the mounting jig. That camera either needs to be adjustable because we are doing an adjustment or an alignment of the camera to the system, or it needs to be a fair representation of how the camera is going to be mounted in its final configuration. For instance, the gun mount on a system. So we want that to be the way we mount the camera to determine the proper alignment of the system. And these are all generally calculated in advance. The mounts, in the case of a line of sight test, are usually custom specific for that application. So that is the most important. Procedurally, if we're just doing a line of sight test, we take the image once, we measure the error, and we're done. If we're doing an alignment, then what we will do is take our measurement, determine the error, and then adjust the camera, again, usually using the jig, to minimize that error, to correct for the error, and then run the boresight again to determine if there's any residual error. And we'll just keep doing this until our error is within our acceptable limits. Application. We've mentioned a couple of applications where it's used. We would call that using it to characterize the system or to calibrate the system. We don't really use this to compare different models. What we're trying to do is look at a camera coming off of a production line and making sure that it is aligned or properly jigged into the system so that we know that it's pointing where we expect it to be. And that's the Boresight test.